Welcome here to more Talk FCB and welcome here to a Barcelona news roundup with a lot of things today that I felt we really needed to discuss. In particular, we're going to be focusing in today's video on player sales, in particular, the potential overhaul we could see this summer. And I'm really hoping that it happens. We're going to be talking about that in a lot of detail. And I'm also going to be bringing you some absolutely staggering details. Honestly, what I'm going to tell you here about Coutinho, it is a joke. Really is coming up today. Let's just do it. Because obviously earlier today, if you haven't seen it yet, over on Talk FCB, we've spoken there about the possibility of early elections, all of that kind of stuff, and also the latest in terms of who is going to replace Setién as the Barca coach. But if we now look at the front pages of the Catalan sports papers this morning, and in particular, they're, like I say, focusing on those player sales, because Sport there lead with the headline, State of Emergency. They basically outlined their three major steps the club are looking to take now to try to turn around the fortunes right now of Barcelona, whereas MD focused much more on Ronald Koeman, as we discussed in the video earlier on. However, what you will notice as a constant in both papers are the very intriguing reports there surrounding the potential sales we could see at the club this summer, and in particular, with several key players being on that transfer list. Because on the one hand there, you've got Sport. They've actually come out and said Barca this summer are planning not just a few players leaving, but they are planning a complete overhaul. They go as far to say that 17 first team players have all been made available for transfer. If the offers come in, if the offers arrive, they can leave. They say there that list includes the likes of Luis Suarez, who could be on his way out, even Sergio Busquets and Jordi Alba, with only the likes of Messi, De Jong, Ter Stegen and Clement Longley assured of their places at the club, which would be massive. That would be a huge summer. Obviously, I'm not saying that all of those players, 17 first players, are going to leave, but to actually make them available for transfer, that's a big step too. But is it going to happen? MD run a similar story. They're, of course, the source there closer to the club than Sport are, and their report isn't as extreme there as saying that pretty much all of the squad are up for sale. But they do say the club are planning significant exits this summer, in particular, naming Suarez, Alba, and Samuel Umtiti as three players who could be on their way out. Which is interesting there if you compare the two lists, and in particular, the names mentioned on those lists, Jordi Alba and Luis Suarez, appearing there on both sides of those stories. That's interesting there, and certainly something to keep an eye on. It was also reported there in the Madrid media from AS that obviously several Barcelona players, you may have already seen this, they've already headed off on their holidays. That, to be honest, doesn't surprise me all that much, but it was interesting there to see AS report that both Martin Braithwaite and Ivan Rakitic haven't just left, but they've actually cleared out their locker. They've gone to the club there, taken all of their belongings, which is usually a hint towards a player leaving that summer, but we're going to have to wait and see whether or not that is true, where they'd get that kind of information from. It would be interesting, but I just want to talk here about that squad overhaul, because I think, to be honest, looking at the club's problems right now, you can talk about the coach, of course, you know, we all want Bartomeu removed as the president, that is something that we're all very, very clear on, but I think we're also under no illusions as a fan base that for quite some time now, we've needed serious changes to this playing squad, and I think in particular the core of that team. I'm not just talking here about a few fringe players bringing in, strengthening the squad. You need a massive change, a structural change to this team, because it's not just this season. We said this last year. We could have avoided everything we've seen over the past year if we'd have acted sooner. But the biggest problem that I can see now, maybe the club do want to move players on. Maybe the club do want to have a big overhaul. But the problem is, you look at the way we played this season. You look at the way we played now in the Champions League. The extremely public humiliation that we suffered. The world was watching the other night. The world watched the performances of many of our players out there. And the question I'd ask is, who's buying them? Who is actually this summer going to come in, pay the money to buy those kind of players? Honestly, that is the question I'd ask. Because let's remember too, we are in the midst of a pandemic. Who is going to be paying sizable transfer fees? Or at the very least, even if the transfer fees are not going to be that big, it's still big salary. We all know about these players, the highest paid players in the world of football. That's a joke. The fact that these players are massively paid, and still they perform as we saw against Bayern Munich. And it's quite simple. The players that we have, the majority of our squad, are not good enough. But how are you going to get rid of them? And this is the problem for me when I look at the board. And even if now they do, like I say, want to shift some players out, it's kind of too late. Because that's the problem. You've got to be ahead of the game. You've got to be ahead of the curve. You have to plan ahead. That is literally your job as a board of directors. You've got so many staff there in place. You've got to see these things coming. You've got to anticipate these kind of moments. And we should have been selling these players well before now. You shouldn't be letting it get to this stage whereby we got players well into their 30s, 32, 33, 34, and now you're trying to move them on. It's not going to happen. It's not going to be easy. And you may certainly see this summer, if we're trying to get rid of players, we might have to give players away for free. In particular there, you think of Rakitic going to Sevilla. Sevilla have already come out and said, look, we can't really afford him. Especially the wages, the transfer fee, it's going to be economically difficult for us. And I think in the end, if we are going to let Rakitic go, it's going to have to be on a free. We're going to end up giving these players away because quite simply, that's the only way it's going to happen. Because the board have waited far too long. As always with their planning, they're so far behind. And on the subject there of the board, we do move on to Felipe Coutinho. And like I say, this for me is just staggering. This is the icing on a very bad cake. Because Coutinho, as we know, January 2018, he was signed by Barcelona from Liverpool, brought in there by Bartomeu for 120 million euros as a fixed fee, plus 40 million in variables, which made him there the most expensive signing in Barcelona's entire history. He's the biggest signing we've ever made, brought in by the current board. And that in itself, it is staggering. But it's even more staggering when you actually put that fee alongside what Bayern Munich paid for their starting 11 on Friday night. Remember, of course, that Coutinho was on the bench for Bayern. Our biggest ever signing was on the bench for the opposition team. And look at their lineup. Their entire team cost less than what we paid for Felipe Coutinho. Now that, for me, that tells you everything you need to know about the way we spent money, about the way the board plan. It is absolutely shambolic. And you know what? It gets worse. It actually gets worse than that. Because as I mentioned before, Coutinho there was signed for 120 million fixed plus 40 million in variables. Now, some of those variables are still outstanding. One of those variables is that if Coutinho wins the Champions League. Now, everybody kind of expected that must mean that Coutinho has to win the Champions League with Barcelona, and then apparently we have to pay Liverpool then a fee based on that trophy win. But you know what? The board have agreed to a ridiculous clause. Because that doesn't just mean Coutinho winning it with Barca. It just means Coutinho winning the Champions League. And that is confirmed, by the way. So, if Coutinho wins the Champions League with another team, with Bayern Munich this season, we will then have to pay Liverpool 5 million euros. And it just makes no sense. Number one, why would you agree to that clause? Number two, when you had agreed to that ridiculous clause, why then would you think, okay, we're going to save money on Coutinho, our biggest ever signing, so what we're going to do, we're going to loan him out to one of the Champions League favourites. That sounds like a great idea. Why don't we do that? Fast forward now, several months, Coutinho scores twice against his own club in the quarterfinal. Bayern are big favourites to win the Champions League. And if they do, we've lost more money. Oh, bravo, Bartomeu. Bravo. You've really outdone yourself now. And honestly, guys, it is absolutely staggering when you move here from situation to situation and you look at the absolute mess this current board has got us in. And I just keep saying it, but you can look at the players, you can look at the coach, but above everything, looking down on this entire massacre of a situation, it is Bartomeu. It is the board, the leadership, the planning. It is like banging your head against the wall. And if there's just one thing, one single thing that we can be thankful for right now, that we can be grateful for as a fan base, even in these moments, even in humiliation, Bartomeu's time, it is running out. We are so close now. We are getting closer and closer to eliminating this virus from our club. Please, please come as soon as possible. So that right there, guys, is the latest when it comes to Barcelona and the potential changes we could see to the playing squad this summer. But like I say, who do you imagine is going to come out and buy these players? What exits would you like to see? And how are we going to make them possible? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. And of course, let me know on that Coutinho situation. It is ridiculous from top to bottom. I will see you soon with more videos to come. Thanks again for your support. Keep your heads up. Keep fighting, and until next time, Visca El Barça!